views in SQL are also known as virtual table, and how to create a view in MySQL, we'll be learning about that in this session. So hello everyone and a very warm welcome to AWS Cube Tech. My name is Aishi Jain, and in this video we are going to talk about views in MySQL. How to create a view is very simple, guys. For example, before we start the video, if you want to become a successful data analyst with AWS Cube, then AWS Cube Tech is bringing their premium data analytics mentorship program. Its cohort 2 is launching in September. So if you want to be a part of this journey with AWS Cube, then click on apply now. Now let's get started, guys. Here we have been given this data called as classic models. Here we have table. I want to create a virtual table. Let's say on a daily basis, I want to analyze some kind of data. Could be based on a join or could be anything. For example, let's say I have created a join over here. Let's create a join first of all between our order details and products. So from our products table, I'm going to choose products that select product dot, or let's call the product table as p dot product name comma, and from our order details table. So let's open order details. In our order details table, we have quantity ordered. We also have the price of each product. So let's also write the product line that p dot product line comma from our order details. Let's call order details as O, order details dot quantity ordered. And we also want the price of each product. So the name of quantity ordered is basically quantity ordered, and O dot price each. Okay, I believe these are the name of the column, price each and the quantity ordered. And from our products table, we have product name and product line as well. Okay. Now, I believe the L in product line is also capital. Now, from our table one is product. And as we have named it as P, we are going to write as P. From product as P in a join order details as O. On the basis of what? In both of them, what is common? Product code is common. So even if I open products table, so here you'll notice that in the products table, what do we have is product code. And in here in the order details, again, we have product code. So how we can join on the basis of product code? So on p dot product code is equal to o dot product code again. This is my table. This is my analysis that I have driven from here. Okay, so this is my table basically whenever my each of the product was ordered, and if you want you can get the order number as well. Okay, so O dot order number. Okay, so we have these few things. Order number, keep the order number in on the top. Let's keep it on the top. So I'm gonna keep this one here, put a comma right after order number, and here we do not have the data because I have missed an O from here. Okay, so here we have the order number. We also have the product name, we have the product line, the quantity ordered, and the price each. Now let's say every day I want to analyze this data. So every day I'm not going to write this query. What I can do is I can create a view out of it. How? Just write create view, and the name of our view is, let's say, sales and orders. So SNO, let me just call it SNO, which will be sales and orders data, as this is our table. Okay. So once I run it, no, we will not receive any output. If I refresh it, you'll see in the views we have a table SNO, and if I open this, in this SNO we have that same data which we obtained through that query. And now with the help of SNO we can write anything, that let's say select product name, or maybe anything, that select sum of quantity ordered from SNO where product line is equal to motorcycles. And if I run this, we have our sum which is 0. Okay, let me just see. Okay, the spelling of motorcycles is wrong, that's why. So the sum is motorcycle, and here the quantity ordered is 12,778. So here we have our output. So what you can do is, instead of writing a whole query where we can put a whole join, you can create a view out of this. This view could be based on anything. All you need to do is on the top of your query, just write create view SNOS. So the name over here is optional. Whatever name you want to give to your table, it is actually a virtual table. So whatever name you want to give to your table, you can give it, and here you can create a virtual table for yourself. It will not act like actual table which has a primary key, constraint or anything. It will just be a virtual table which you have created from your own query. It can contain a simple query as well, or it can contain a complex queries as well. I hope it is clear how to create a view. If anytime you want to create a view, just start like create view. Let's call it France as select everything from customers where country is equal to France. And once I run this query and refresh it, here we have a table which is named as France. And if I open this, I have data of all the customers who are from France. So yes, simply you can write your query, and just before your query, you can write create view, name of your view, and use as, so that you can create a query right after that. You can write a query just right after that. So this is how you can create a view easily using SQL. I hope it is clear to you. And for more such SQL related videos, stay tuned, guys. Thank you.